Would you like to learn why documentation is one of the most critical skills for cloud architects, enterprise architects, and solutions architects? Would you like to learn why we spend approximately 20% of our time as architects writing documentation? I'm always talking about that cloud architect job description and what we do with a cloud architect. And the reason I do it is so many people misconfuse a cloud architect and a cloud engineer, or an enterprise architect with an engineer. And they think that the architect role involves a lot of hands-on building. We don't build anything. I like to say we design, present, and sell. And there's a lot of documentation that goes on to what we do as architects. So let's talk about the documentation we do as cloud architects, enterprise architects, and solutions architects, and why this is so critical. Well, if we look at the role, it's a strategic planning role, and we have to be able to communicate our ideas across a wide variety of individuals. And documentation is one of the ways we do this. So these are the types of documents that we write as a cloud architect, enterprise architect, or a solutions architect. The first thing is RFIs, RFPs, RFQs. What are these things? They're either requests for information, requests for proposal, or requests for quote. So if we are working for the end customer, we will be writing an RFI, RFP, RFQ, and sending it to various vendors like IBM or Accenture or AWS or Microsoft or Google or Cisco and say, what can you do for us? What's the price that your solution would be for us? That kind of thing. And if we're in one of these end customers, we're responding to these to show why our solution is the right one for our client. Another document we do a lot of writing is something called the business case. And here's the thing, if somebody's going to invest $1 billion in technology, and that's not uncommon, we need to show the business reasons for it and how that technology will optimize that client's business and financial performance. So we're going to write a lot of business cases. We will also write a lot of what's called statements of work. And okay, now we have an architecture that we designed and another team's going to come in and build it. So what type of people do we need? How many people do we need? How long is the project going to take? That kind of thing, that's part of the statements of work. Now, another kind of document we cloud architects, enterprise architects, and solutions architects are going to be writing is our guiding architecture principles. So what are the principles designing this architecture? So that type of a thing. We may actually write documents on technology reference models. We could be writing documents on architecture guidelines. So for every new application, for example, that's going to be deployed on the web, publicly facing, this is what that demilitarized zone needs to look at. So for example, so that architecture guidelines we're going to be writing a lot of. We'll be mapping out business capabilities and we'll be documenting business capability models. What is this business good at? What is its strengths, weaknesses, that type of thing. We will be writing technology roadmaps. Okay, here's the company today. Here's where we want to go in the future. And here's the roadmap of all the technologies necessary to get them there. We will be writing responses on our architectural solutions and the overview. We will write that for executives. We'll be writing deeper documentation for our customers, our clients, deeper technology professionals. We will be creating solution designs, and that's not just going to be a picture. That's going to be a document that explains every element of that design. We may be working in the context of an enterprise architecture framework like TOGAF or Zachman, and in many cases we are or should be. And we're going to document whatever framework we did or however we tailored that so that other architects of a part of the team will understand as well as key stakeholders. We're always going to be documenting current state. Before we move anything, we need to know what it is. Or before we plan any migration, we need to know what it is. So we'll be documenting that. We'll also be documenting the future state, which is what the architecture is going to look like in the future. And that's inclusive of the organization's people, processes, and technologies, not just the technology. So we will also be writing a lot of gap analysis reports. So what is a gap analysis? The gap analysis is that here's where the customer is today, or here's where their technology platform is, here's where they want to go, here's their future technology platform. What's the difference, the delta, or the gap between them? And that's always going to be critical in any architecture. We may be documenting enterprise data models and how that enterprise may use data. We're definitely going to be documenting whatever IT governance frameworks we help create as architects. We typically will have some security architecture documents that we'll collaborate with the security team. maybe some integration strategy documents that we're going to write about how the technology platforms are going to integrate. In the average enterprise, we have, say, 200 to 1,000 various applications. So we're constantly thinking about the integration of our clouds, of our applications, of our network, of our security, all the things. If one business buys another business, for example, we typically get involved in a lot of risk mitigation reports. So we evaluate an organization's risks. We quantify it from a quantitative perspective. We look at the qualitative things like brand damage. We work with that organization to determine, you know, do you transfer that risk to an insurance company? Do you mitigate that risk with some things like next generation firewalls, IDS, IPS systems, and encryption chain, that type of a thing. Whenever we architects design an architecture, we really need to know what does that customer consider success? Is their goal to decrease operating expenses in their business? Is their goal to increase revenue? What have you? So we have to determine that. And is the IT getting that business to its goals? Along with, if the business needs 99.999% availability, what are we delivering? Lots of documentation on that. Cloud migration strategy documents, that's another thing that we're going to be writing constantly. We're also going to be writing what's called thought leadership documents, especially if we work for a vendor. Maybe if we're working for a cloud provider or a tech provider or a consulting provider, and we're writing a document on either how the technology impacted another customer in a positive way or how this new technology can be used for business. So as you can see, we do a lot of writing as cloud architects, enterprise architects, and solutions architects. And writing is going to be one of those most critical cloud architect skills, enterprise architect skills, and solutions architect skills. So if this is a role you want, make sure you develop your documentation skills, because that's going to be very critical for the role. If you'd like to become a cloud architect, an enterprise architect, an AI architect, a security architect, or any other architect for that matter, we've got free ebooks and free webinars to assist you in your IT architecture career. Check it out in the description of this video, register for a free webinar on Zoom, and we can meet, we can talk, and we can answer any questions you may have. We additionally have many free resources in the description of this video. Anything from guides on how to help you win the interview to what we do as cloud architects, enterprise architects, etc., AI architects, the skills you need to get hired and have a successful career. And they're all free, so go check them out. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your architecture career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now. I hope to see you in a free webinar or on another YouTube video. Take care.